All right, hello everyone, and peace of Christ to all of you. I think my voice now is coming good and clear, right? What happened? It's Google mistake. You know, they could not, sales could not recognize the microphone, so choose a microphone which is not the one I use. Anyway, so the problem is solved, I hope. And we start our topic by saying, don't forget, please, to download the video immediately after we finish and share it with your friends. Not only share the link, because the link will not stay anyway. I don't keep my videos, and we need to download them. Today, our topic about fairy tale stories. Now, all of us, we like fairy tale stories, especially when we were kids. You know, I remember when I was a kid, you know, like all children's, you know, like Flying Carpet, Aladdin. I mean, those stories, they are fun for children's. And today, because of the amazing graphic ability, where you can create something unreal and make it look real, which is impossible before in the movie business, we can have something look amazing, you know, but still it's a fairy tale story. And graphic will not make it real. Now, Muhammad is a person who speaks for God, and he claimed that he is God sent. He got tons of stories in the Quran. Not only they don't make sense to the people at that time, they don't make sense to people at this time. Not only people at that time, they found them silly and stupid. And remember, I mean, at that time, people are less educated, right? So it's very easy to make people believe in some stories. Most of people don't know how to read, how to write, and no education. Education was only for specific people. Let us say some society, they are totally ignorant, you know. So it's very easy to make people believe in anything when you are naive. But even the naive Arab, they said to Muhammad, and we will show you that from the Quran, that this is nothing but the fairy tale stories of the ancient. Even the Arab, who they are uneducated, Bedouin, who live in a tent, even those naive people, Muhammad, he could not convince them with their stories. So, one of the things we hear from Muslims always, that the Quran is a book of science. I say the Quran is a book of Hobbit. Is that how they say the name of the movie, Hobbit? This is actually, even this movie is a lot better. The scenario, the author, he took care of many things. As an example, if you go in the Quran, suddenly you will hear about names and there's no introduction for them. Who are they? We do not know. What they play, we didn't know. Who, what they do, what is their job, we don't know. Where they live, we do not know. In the movie, you see that this guy is a brother for this guy, and this guy is from this family, and they live in such a land. And you will see even the trees who they are moving in the movie, there is introduction for them. Even the talking tree. In the Quran, there's no introduction for anything. Suddenly, a name jump in front of you from the middle of nowhere. And if you search the whole book, which is called the Quran, you will not find any reference about who is this person. As an example, Israel. If we ask the Muslims, Israel, who is Israel? They don't know. Okay. Who is Idris? They don't know. Saleh? They don't know. Where they live? They don't know. They don't know. I mean, there's tons of names. They know nothing about them. They are there. And one of the funny things Muslims, they say to us, that at that time, Allah, he challenged the Arab to make Quran like him. Not only I find this challenge is very silly, because if I am God, I mean, what kind of a challenge to say, okay, make a book like me, I'm Allah. You know, this is silly. I mean, Allah competing with a human. But only Muslims, they claim nobody can make Quran like this. But look what the Quran said. The Quran get the lies busted. The Arab at that time, they said to Muhammad, this is a silly, stupid book, and if we want, we can make something like it. Read it. This is a chapter 8, verse number 31. You go anywhere, this says the Arab, he challenged him to make like it, and they told him, no, we cannot make like it. They did not say we cannot make like it. They say this is a silly book. It's a fairy tale stories. And not only that, they said to him, we heard these stories. We heard them. All your stories you told us, it's a stupid fairy tale story. We heard them before. This is the tale of the ancients. So how the tale of the ancients became the tale of Allah? You know what I mean? How the tale of the ancient became the tales of Allah. So this is our topic today. Please, guys, invite your friends. Many people lost connection with our previous podcast because we have difficulty with the sound. I found a genie in the genie. If you go right now and search in Google about having sex with the genie, you will find tons and tons of articles, books. Muslims believe, if you have my book, Sex and Allah, Muslims believe that a genie, he will have sex with his wife. There's a guy, he called in TV station, he say, Assalamu alaikum, brother. Wa alaikum assalam, brother. I have a question, brother. Okay, what question, brother? Hey, brother, I opened the door of my wife's bedroom, and I saw her doing things to herself. You know, she is touching herself. And now, there is no shame in Islam. I mean, the guy is calling TV, live TV. Millions will hear this, that his wife, she was touching her private part. And then the guy in the TV, he says to him, brother, obviously she was having sexual intercourse with the genie. If you see in my book, you will find that there's a guy, he witnessed that he saw a fire in the bushes of his wife. You know what bushes I'm talking about. And this is a proof that she was having sex with the genie. Because genie are made from fire according to the Quran. So obviously, if you have sex with the fire, you will get in fire. You know, I mean, it's obvious. Hello. You know, so even Muhammad, he says to them, before you have intercourse, before you have intercourse, you have to say a certain prayer. Otherwise, Shaitan, he will rub himself around your private part. And he will have sex with your wife when you are doing it. And then the son will be the son of Shaitan. Do we have any Muslim want to say anything? Anyone? So where those stories are coming from? Allah in the Quran, he challenged mankind for many things, and one of them, that you cannot go out of the earth. A mistake Muhammad, he did, because he never thought people would do it. Okay. When we have a God who challenged that you cannot leave, and the only one can leave is the one who gets permission from Allah, and those are the believers who they are going to be taken to heaven, specifically the prophets. First of all, where Muhammad, he got the idea that there is a creatures, they are called genie. You will find that the idea of a genie, the existence of a genie as a creature, goes long before Islam and have nothing to do even with the Arab. So Muhammad is a magnetic collector of stories which exist around him. He takes the story and he make it as a part of his book, and he claimed that Allah is the one who created the genie. And now Allah is challenging the genie to go out of the zone of the earth. Now here you see, actually, if Allah is a true God, then he should not allow this to happen. Why? Because if you try to go out of the zone of the earth, by the way, Allah will shoot your ass with a flash of fire. Do you see it? And the funny, which make it more funny and more hilarious, the first one who went to the moon or out of the zone of the earth, it was the kuffar, the Russian. And here, literally, the claim of the Muslims that Islam speak of science got busted. I mean, what kind of, you are saying to me, oh company of a human and genie, leave the zone of the earth if you can, and you go read the interpretation. This says nobody can do that except Allah giving permission to his prophet, like Muhammad, he fly in the top of a flying mule. And here you see the Muslims, they have a, they have an article speaking about Allah. He spoke about spaceship. What spaceship? It was a mule. It was a creature from the family of donkeys or horses, and Muhammad described it between the size. It was brought al-Buraq, who was an animal white and long. In which movie we have this guy, the old guy, he is that in the same movie? He is riding a horse, can fly. The guy with the gray hair. There's the magician who have a stick in his hand. Is that in the same movie, guys? Is that the same movie? In the Lord of the Ring? Okay, Lord of the Ring. Hold on, let's search for, so we can give you an idea. Lord of the Ring. All right. Here we go. Yeah, this guy, he have a horse which is white. Let us see where we can find there's tons of pictures, but we want to find, we are not getting lucky. Yeah, like this, this is a story here. So this horse can fly, this horse can go anywhere, this horse can. So Muhammad, Allah, he sent him a horse, actually not a horse, an animal which is between the size of a donkey and between the size of a horse. So we can say he is a mule. And here you ask yourself, you know, in any story in the world, there is always a witness for something. Always the stories of Muhammad, nobody saw it. It's only Muhammad who witnessed, and he tell the story. God, he sent a huge animal. I was brought al-Buraq, who was an animal, white and long. And it had to be white, by the way, because Allah will not allow anything is black to enter his heaven. You know, this is a supremacist cult, a racist cult, where everything inside the heaven are white. To the point, even Allah in the Quran says that يوم تسود وجوه وتبيض وجوه. So, the day where Allah will make faces black and faces white. And according to the story, there is a beast will come from the ground and will have the same stick as the stick of this guy in the movie. This beast, he will have a stick in his hand, and he will have the ring of Solomon, exactly like the ring of the Lord movie. And he will hit you with the ring, and he will hit you with the stick. By hitting you, he make you either black or white. Now, how in the world anyone can believe in this? How Muslims can believe in that? And the ring. And if you read the story of Muhammad, where it says, I was brought al-Buraq, who was an animal white and long, larger than a donkey but smaller than a mule, who would place his hoof a distance equal to the range of horizon. I mean, look how small he is, but look how his hoof is. I mean, even the Lord of the Ring, he could not do that, right? The movie. So his hoof, would place his hoof a distance equal to the range of horizon. I mounted it and I came to Bayt al-Maqdis. By the way, there's nowhere it says, like when the Muslim they say Al-Aqsa. Nowhere it says that this is in Jerusalem, like in the Quran. So suppose it's Jerusalem. Then he threaded it in a ring used by the Prophet. Look at this story here. Now there is a ring. I mean, here we go. Okay, you want the guy to take a mule sent by Allah, and you don't want him to tie it up, and he will run. But hold on, when Allah send you a mule, I mean, the guy, he came from the seven galaxy all the way to you, to your house, and now you are worried he will leave you. So what we do, we tie him in a ring which is used by the Prophet. And then when he entered the mosque, I prayed two rak'ah, which means two bowing. And then Jibreel came out, brought me a vessel of wine and a vessel of milk. I chose the milk, and Jibreel said, "You have chose the natural thing." Then he took me to the heaven. Jibreel, then he asked the gate at the heaven to be open. And he was... Hold on. All right. Do you remember this scene in the movie? Do you remember it? So Muhammad now, he is in the front of the gate. And Jibreel, he asked the gate to be open. Interesting. And then the angels, they said, "Who is with you?" What? He ordered him to open the gate. They did not open the gate right away. There is investigation first. He was asked, "Who is he? Who he was?" Look, the angels do not know Jibreel. I thought Jibreel is the mighty one. He is the head of the angels. Like, imagine a Trump, he go in TV and nobody recognize him. He says, "Who's this guy?" Like, who's this? You know what I mean? Like, who are you? He said, "Jibreel." He was again asked, "And who is with you?" Jibreel said, "Muhammad." And then he said to him, "He been asked to come? Like, he been sent for? Like, did somebody call him?" Jibreel said, "Yes, indeed, he has been sent for." Look, those the guys in the door, they have no idea about the new visitors. He have no idea about who is Jibreel. They never saw Jibreel before. And here you notice that the author of the story is not only a fool, he is just a too much dummy. I mean, Jibreel coming backward, forward, coming back, forward, backward, forward, backward. How many times Muhammad, he went, he received message from Jibreel. Jibreel, go up the sky, come down. It's like elevator. All this time, those guys did not notice who's Jibreel. And now they are asking him, "Who are you?" And this is why we say the stories of Harry Potter and the Hobbit, Lord of the Ring, are 1,000 times more, written better. We can't say logical, everything there is stupid. But it's more logical in the story. I mean, at least those are men. Nobody claimed to be God, but he claimed that they have magic, etc. Now we have an angel of God, and the other angel asking him, who are you? And then Jibreel, he said, I'm Jibreel. Okay, what if somebody else, he said, I'm Jibreel? How you know that is Jibreel? If you could not recognize him by the look, just because he said, I am Jibreel. Yeah, we will go to that, Isaac. Thank you for saying that. Isaac is asking, let us show you the question of Mr. Isaac. That's a good question. I encourage people always to think. And, you know, that's mean you guys are focusing and they are learning. Isaac, he said, well, didn't the journey take 1,000 years for one way? How Muhammad can make it? That's a good question. As long as the Quran says that you, in order for the angels to go to the sky, you need 1,000 years to go up and 1,000 years to come down. Okay. So now Muhammad is going up to heaven. Muhammad is going up to heaven. This journey, which Muhammad he did in 8 hours or less, according to the Quran, it should take 1,000 years just to go. And this is why we say that Muhammad obviously is a very ignorant person, and he don't, you know, he don't know how to make a story. Like he always get himself busted, and he got his lies exposed. Qasim, he's a Muslim. Let us show you what Mr. Qasim he said. I encourage Muslims to try to answer, no problem. If you want to call me, you can call me Qasim. He said, well, Allah can take him faster, but no problem. But as you see, he is a company to the angels and a mule. So who is the one who took him? An angel. What the speed will be? It's in the Quran. It takes them 1,000 years just to go. So don't tell me Allah can take him faster. Yes, this is can be true if the story says, okay, Allah says, Allah said to Muhammad, come, and Muhammad was there. And here, this is exposed another point. Thank you for saying that. Because a Muslim, they say, if Allah wants something to happen, he say, be. Here we go. He want Muhammad to come to heaven. Did he say be and he was? No. He sent him a donkey. And I don't know what the connection between the donkey and going to the sky. As long as the angel is there. I mean, why the angel don't take him? What is the need of the donkey? Hmm? The angels, Jibreel is there. So we have an animal who have a physical body, and we have an angel who obviously have physical body too, because Muhammad described the angel, how big he is. He have 600 wings. How many wings, Qasim, the angels have? Is it true that the angel Jibreel have 600 wings? Qasim? Muslims, how many wings the angels have according to your prophet? When Muhammad, he saw his angel Jibreel, how many wings he have? How many? 600 wings. And the hadith confirmed that. We can search right now for the hadith, and you will see the hadith confirmed that the prophet, he saw Jibreel, and he have 600 wings. Okay. So Muhammad, he saw an angel, and he have 600 wings, as you see. All right, but isn't it the Quran says that the angels have 2, 3, and 4 wings? Here again, you notice that the author of the Quran is an idiot, because when you make a story, you cannot say different story with different stuff. I mean, this is stupid. How the Quran says that this is the this is how Allah he created the angels. That's it. Okay, how he created the angels? Let us see. All right. Let us go here. All right. Alhamdulillahi fatir al-samawati wal-ard, ja'il al-malaikati, etc. Okay. How? What Allah He made? He made the angels with two wings, three wings, and four wings. And He multiply His creation what He will. But He told us what He made the angels, that's it. And this is in the time of Muhammad. The angel who met with Muhammad, he must have one of those numbers. So how the Quran says, the angels, they have two wings, three wings. By the way, how you can have three wings? Let it. I mean, okay, three wings, what we can do. One in the middle. So two wings, three wings, and four wings. Right? But Muhammad, he said in the hadith that he saw an angel with 600 wings. So one of them is lying. Either the one who wrote the Quran is lying, or the one who made the hadith is lying. But both of them are Muhammad. Sahih Muslim, he was saying how they can, how Muhammad was able to count the numbers of the wings. I will tell you how. You know, we are very fast. We have to admit here. Come on. Sorry, Sahih, you are not an Arab. We Arab, we can count. I mean, you just put in front of me like 1,000 cucumber. Just tell me that they are 1,000, and I will count them right away. In a second, I will tell you it's 1,000. Yeah, we Arab, we can count anything very fast. I mean, it's very easy. You know, Jibreel, he have a tag in his chest. It says, Jibreel with the 600 wings. Hello? Like, come on. I mean, don't make it complicated for Muhammad. He can give you any answer you want. He can call Zakarnaik. You ask Zakarnaik how Muhammad he was able to count that he have 600 wings. He will give you the answer in a very sharp way. He's very smart. But a Christian, they ask how the Prophet was able to count the number of the wings. And especially the flying. It's impossible. It's very easy. If you buy a suit that doesn't have a number in it, so I don't need to look at your suit moving. All what I need to see is the number of the suit. And that's it. I will get it. So this is Jibreel. He is in the side of 600. Did you watch the movie? It's called The 300 from Sparta. Why they call him The 300? They can keep moving. But because they call themselves The 300. So everybody knows that they are 300, but nobody count The 300. So it's up. I got you busted, and you know it.
I mean, isn't it easy?
Everybody knows that Jibreel have 600 wings. So Muhammad, he got the number from there. Hello? He did not count them.
You cannot deviate Zakarnaik. Come on. By the way, I just made Zakarnaik did not say that. This is my all the unless I say Zakarnaik, he said, and I mean it, then this is I made up.
So what do you think, Muslims? How in the world this guy, he can be a prophet of God? I mean, he is one guy, one witness, one message, one messenger, one God. His name is Allah, but the story doesn't match. So what's happened? How Muhammad know to count? That's very easy, my friend. I will tell you. Like once I was in the highway driving, and I heard in the news they were saying, you know, I'm an Arab, so they were saying an Arab guy driving in the highway 102, and he is driving in the wrong direction. I heard them in the news. I heard the news. The radio was there, and I said to myself, this radio station is stupid. I mean, it's not only one. I start counting just to show you how I can count. I said one. Look how many they are driving in the wrong direction. One, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, I mean, until I arrived to 600. There was 600 people driving in the wrong direction.
and I did not notice it was me. I mean, come on, obviously it's me who is driving in the wrong direction, right? But because we are Arab, we think we are the right one and everybody in the wrong direction. He never thought that this is speaking about him. But it's because it's impossible, brother. We are Arab. So are you saying to me that the Arab prophet who is an Arab like me, he got it wrong? You're no way. We are the Arab. We are the best. And forget about the rest. Yeah, and this is a true story. I mean, I have no witnesses for the stories, but Muslims, they believe, millions believe in a stories, have no witnesses. Why my story need witnesses now? The funny that in the Quran, if you accuse somebody of adultery, you need to have four witnesses, and the four witnesses have to see the intercourse happening. Not only they are like you see a man and a woman naked in the bed. No. Not only you see them moving, you know, we cannot describe. You have to see the private part of the man going in and out. If you don't see that, there's no adultery. This is Islam, and this is in the Quran, by the way. Four witnesses in the Quran. Muhammad, he explained it. He says, the same as the pen go in the inkwell. Yeah, this is how you have to see the private man going inside the private part of the woman. Okay, this is impossible. You go to the bedroom, you find yourself your wife having sex with somebody, the cable guy. What do you say, the cable guy? Hey, wait, I'm going to call for witnesses, and please, can you show us how you do it? He will not let you see. But anyway, this is a different topic. But as I'm saying here, I mean, everything in Islam, like just adultery, need for witnesses. How come Muhammad have no witnesses? So as you see, the stories of the same book, the same author, the same prophet does not match with the story of the same prophet, the same book, the same God. Nothing match. What do you think? Do we have any Muslim want to call me? Anyone? Who is a Muslim, a Mohammedan, he think he can prove me wrong? Somebody sending me images like somebody making fun of Christian Prince. Don't talk to them. You see, when you do that, you fuel them. They need you. The one who have a grave, you just say to them two words. Don't debate with those Muslims. There's no debate with the Muslims. You do that. Just tell them, okay, if you are a man, call him. Get him busted life on air. This guy, he keeps saying, who gonna call me? Why you don't call him? They make fun of me in Facebook. And then you want to defend me. Why you want to defend me? No, I do not need anyone to defend me, please. If there is one of them, he have the courage and the knowledge, we are life on air. I do not need anyone to defend. I'm here. You go on YouTube, all the Muslim channels, you will not find one of them there to have open Skype to call to ask questions about Islam. They don't. Right? And because they cannot answer, when the lion is up, the cats disappear, the fox, the hyena, you know, they disappear. The cat appear only when the lion is not there. I'm not saying I'm the lion, because even the lion have stories in Islam. It would be funny. We showed you just yesterday how the prophet of Allah, he claimed that when the lion, he sneeze, there's two cats come from his nose. One is male and one is female. I'm afraid to sneeze now. Otherwise, all of them, they are heroes. All the Muslims can refute me. Have you ever heard of a Muslim? He cannot refute me. No way. Yeah, yesterday in the video yesterday. By the way, always when you when we make a video, you don't find it no more in my channel. Just search for the same title and go to filter like last 24 hours ago. And then you will find a list of people downloading my videos, and I'm very thankful for them. You can watch it there, and you can download it too. All right. So who is the Muslim would like to call us and tell us what is how Islam can be from God? Why they say to us that Islam is a have science. Islam, Quran is a book of science. Like yesterday, we have a Muslim who called me and he said, "What about fingerprint? We got that busted. What about else? What he mentioned many things. We got them busted. It's a lie." So who is the Muslim gonna call us right now? Any Muslim? The only speed of light I know. I mean, are you saying to me the donkey of the prophet was in the speed of light? If this is the case, well, the donkey did not pass, not even like 1 to 1 billion from the distance to go out of our galaxy. Anyone? Is it true that Jibreel in Allah's throne? As I know, it's Muhammad in Allah's throne. There's tons of stories about, you know, Muhammad, Muhammad and his family and Ali, etc. You know, it's madness. Mahdi is saying, every year a miracle happened in the name of what his name? Hussein. Look at this, guys. Do you know, CP, that every year a miracle happened on the day of Ashura? Okay, let's see. Look like your Hussein, he activate his miracle only in the day of Ashura. I mean, your Hussein, he did not make any miracle when he was alive, and he said all stupid things. What about Ali? Is no different. What about Muhammad? Miracle happened in the name of Hussein, like what? Breastfeeding for adult. Muta, since when miracles happen? But Hussein, yeah, right. You're a prophet, he spent his life, he could not heal even a cat. According to Muslims, the children of Muhammad, they die, and he could not do anything about it. Is that right? What miracle? The only miracle is how somebody, he have you know, he in the age of computer and internet, he believe in such a garbage. This is the only miracle. Flying carpet, the prophet Solomon, he wanted a bathroom. Anyone save the link we read from before about King Solomon and his ring? If somebody have it, save me that English one. If you somebody have it from the admin, you can please post it so we can put it in the screen. Guys, look at the story Muhammad he came with. Prophet Solomon, he have a ring. And obviously this ring belonged to the Lord of the ring. Okay. Solomon, he cannot take the ring which is given to him by Allah to the bathroom. So what Suleiman he did? Each time he wanna go to the bathroom, he have to take off the ring from his hand. Hmm? Everybody want to steal the ring. Everybody want to steal the ring. Shaitan, when Suleiman, he went to the bathroom, he came and he took the ring. He came in the look of Suleiman. Look how crazy this stuff is. He put the ring in his hand, and right away he became the king. And Suleiman, he became a porter who carried stuff for people in the street. Poor, and he was kicked out from the palace. Because in Islam, all what you need to do to be a king is just to get the ring. And I challenge any Muslim to say I'm lying. Anyone? And how Suleiman he got the ring? Oh, I don't want to forget to mention what happened in during that time. Suleiman, now he kicked out from the palace, but the shaitan, he took the look of Suleiman. And now he start having sex with his wives. How the wives of Suleiman, they noticed that this is cannot be the true Suleiman. Anyone remember? How the wives of Suleiman, they noticed that this is cannot be Suleiman, the real Suleiman. Even though he looked exactly like Suleiman. They notice because he is so good in bed. The guy, he never take a break. Who's next? A prophet, do you want to take a break? I cannot take a break. I can't stop. Next. Like the woman, like, what the heck? How this guy can do it? He never... Do you want to eat? No, I cannot eat. Next, who is the next woman? Do you want to go to the bathroom? I don't go to the bathroom. I need next woman. Next woman. Come on, faster. Non-stop boom, boom. And this is how they notice this is cannot be our husband. We believe it. For sure you believe it. You are a Muslim. And then they reported Suleiman. The fake Suleiman, I mean. To the elders of the kingdoms. And now the elders, they start investigating the story. This is one of the elders. And he asked him, like, really? Is that how he had sex? Are you sure? I mean, how you Muslim believe in those stories? You tell me. Let us see if we can find a website in English, a Muslim website. All right. Okay, we found a website, but I'm not sure if this is telling us the whole story. Let us see. All right. Okay, here we go. Just to show you, we are not making things up here. By the way, the Muslim, they have many versions of the story. I mean, even Muhammad, he have many versions of the same story. As usual, all liars, they do that. Whenever Suleiman, he would go to answer in the nature, the call of nature, like farting, whatever. He would remove the ring and give it to his servant. In different story, it's his wife and her name is Jarada. One day, Shaitan fooled the servant and took the ring away inverted himself. At the same moment, all jinn and a human and shaitan and birds and animals came to his presence to obey him. Because that's it. He got the ring. Hello. And you are telling me that Islam is not scientifically accurate? Hello. The guy, he just put the ring in his finger, and all animals, human, chickens, birds, turkey, even rabbits, cats, meow, fish, everybody, dolphin, hey dolphin, come over. We got a new king who wore a new ring, the magical ring. So that's it. I get a ring, and then I control the whole world, brother. Yes, brother. And brother, this story is absolutely truthful. Because this ring, by the way, is very, very special in power, brother. In case you do not know, I have a ring like that. But because I'm nice, I don't want to control you. Just because I'm nice. Otherwise, you will be in a very horrible situation. You know? Actually, in the other day, I used my ring. You know? I put my ring in my hand, and I hit the remote control, and I was controlling the TV. I take the ring off, the remote control doesn't work. By the way, what they call it remote control if you need the ring to make the TV work with it? See? They lie to you. They say, no, you cannot. You see, this is a miracle. I was able to control the TV by when I wear the ring, the remote control work. Actually, I had to change the battery too, to be honest with you. Do we have any Muslim here have anything to say? And here the Muslims are so excited to tell us about what happened. When he Suleiman came out from the toilet, I will never go to the toilet. If I have this ring, I will never go to the bathroom. You know what? I will take the bathroom with me wherever I go. I will do it standing in the balcony. So when Suleiman came out of the toilet, he could not find the ring. Like, what the heck? Where is the ring? And then he saw that the kingship was taken away. If. It happened to me exactly with my laptop. True story. Hello. What is the scientist and the science? And you want me to convert to Islam? You love that sound, Kathy? Okay. Kathy, listen, this is guy just for Kathy because she loved that song. Oof, 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 oof. Okay, we can say it more than three times. That's it. The prophet says, even if you go to the bathroom, you have to shake it three times. That's it. We have to be consistent with Islam. And then, brother, he left the place and he came to the shore of the river. Oof, oof, oof. People of the Israelis. So the behavior of Satan, which is different from Suleiman, between two bracket, because they missed to tell you something. You see, when they told you that he came to the bathroom and he fooled the servant, it was not the servant really, it was his wife, and they did not tell you that he took the look of Suleiman, but he had between two bracket, but he had changed the face to Suleiman. If he changed his face to Suleiman. Are you sure, brother? Yes, brother. So now we have two Suleiman. We have Suleiman the devil, and we have Suleiman the king. How we can recognize which Suleiman is Suleiman? Allah knows best. All right? So he has the face of Suleiman, as you see, and he had sat on his chair. These two traditions are rejected by the Shia ulama. And Suleiman was a prophet of Allah. He is safe from pure of such a sort of sin. So the Shia are saying, this is a Sunni story. We reject the story. Okay, what the Shia story is? What the Shia story? Supposedly the Shia story is better than the Sunni story. Brother, what is the Shia story? Imam said, Mankut means compulsory, wajib, okay, and then he says, let us see. You see here, like they are mixing between Sunni and Shia. I want to see what the Shia say, because this one reason that this Suleiman was sitting in his throne, and he said that tonight I will have sex with 70 women, and each will give him his will give him a birth to a son, and he will fight for Allah. Allah, by the way, Suleiman was ISIS too. Suleiman was ISIS, man, he's a big member in ISIS. And he decided in one night he want to have sex with 70 women, and all of them, they will like boing, 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 they will give like babies. And he will fight for the sake of Allah with the 70. I mean, what's wrong with this guy? He was not thinking about sex all his life. Suddenly he decided to sleep with 70. I mean, okay, where have you been yesterday? What about the week before? Now suddenly you decide, like, he was like thinking, how I can do jihad, how I can do jihad. Okay. Ah, okay. Get my women for me. I want to have sex with all of them in one night. By the way, I don't know how Suleiman, he can only have sex with 70. We Arab, we can do like, I mean, I don't know. My grandfather, this is a true story, by the way. It's existence Sahih al-Bukhari. Allah, he sent him a dish. It's called al-Kufayt. And he got the power of 40 men. My grandfather, his name is the Prophet Muhammad. It looked like Allah, he gave Suleiman the same power, you know, the Kufayt, Shish Kebab. So then he start having sex with the wives. But he forgot to say, inshallah. Look what did. How you do that? Inshallah, which means by Allah willing, or Allah willing. So because he forgot to say, inshallah, Allah gave him, none of the women was able to give him birth to a baby except one. She gave him a child who is in disability. Do you see what happened when you don't say inshallah before sex? Actually, if I get married, I'm going to print in the forehead of my wife, inshallah. To remember that, I don't want to get, come on. Or maybe I will print it in her chest, or maybe in her cheek, or maybe even in her lips. So whatever she speak to me, I remember to say inshallah. We go to, what if the room is dark? Okay, I got a solution. There's a shiny phosphor ink. You turn the light, they shine. I mean, just look at the technology, how it's helping a lot these days. Yeah, you can write in her chest, inshallah, in dark, even is going to shine. And you can install there like a word, inshallah, by LED light. I mean, come on, stop making excuses not to say it. Yeah, neon light. Yeah. Actually, the prophet, he said that when his mother, she gave birth to him, a light reached all the way the palaces of Damascus came from her vagina. This was the first nuke made by the Arab. Okay, hold on. Just a little bit. I'm just trying to understand what happened here. I mean, why you guys, you remind me of those things? Why? So Muhammad is in Mecca. This is Damascus, and this is Mecca. His mother, she is giving birth to him. A light came from her private part. May Allah bless it. And went all the way to Syria and Damascus. If. How that happened, brother? How that happened? From Mecca all the way to Syria and Damascus. Okay, I have a question. Why the light went in one direction? That is a very, very smart. If you ask the question to Zakir Naik, he will say you. I can tell you that you are stupid. I am a doctor, and you know it. Obviously, because it came from her private part. So obviously, her back it was in the direction, and her leg it fit in the mascot. So it's very normal that the light is going to travel and go to the mascot. And this is how I silence me. The funny, the light went all the way to the palaces of Damascus, and people who live in Mecca, they did not see it, not even the neighbor. But we have to admit, everything in Islam have witnesses. Isn't it the Muslim, they witness to Muhammad, the Shahada is a witness. The word Shahada in Arabic means witness, which means you witness that Muhammad is a prophet, but you do not need to witness anything except just say that the words and that's it. Witnessing anything is not necessary in Islam. Who witnessed this miracle that the light came from the private part of Muhammad's mother and she went all the way to the palaces of Syria? Anyone knows in the books of history in the time of Muhammad, any historian wrote, there suddenly a light came to the palaces of Syria. And what happened between? People of Saudi Arabia did not see it. People of Jordan, people of Israel, people of Lebanon, nobody see it. Only from the private part of Muhammad's mother all the way to Damascus. What about what? The curvature of earth? Isaac, I don't know what that word mean, my friend. You know, my English is limited. What curvature? What does that mean? You scare me with that word. But this word is scary. It's like Harry Potter thing. Curvature? Is that English? Man, English people, they have really words. You know, first time I came to America, a guy from the church I went to, he wanted to be nice with me. He said, are you hungry? I said, yes. I was really hungry. And he said, okay, let us eat hot dogs. And my head starts spinning. The guy want to feed me hot dogs? Wow, how sick. And he claimed to be Christian. Hot dogs? He said, let us eat hot dogs. I said, no, I don't want. He said, you just said you are hungry. I said, no, I'm not. I was kidding with you. I mean, he want to feed me hot dogs. You believe me, those American? Kuffar, infidel, dirty. Hot dogs? Show mercy. Are you Chinese? You eat dogs? Unbelievable. So since then I don't eat hot dogs. Sorry. Don't come on. Isaac is talking to me because the earth are round. Yeah, but I don't know what that word mean. The light go to Mecca. From Mecca to Damascus. Yeah, because the earth is flat. Maybe she was shooting like missiles, you know. But the light, as I know, travels straight. Doesn't go like in curves. Unless you put like a glasses in the way or something. Or reflection, a mirror of something. So do we have any Muslim here want to say something to us? Yeah, I know what curve mean, man. Each time you talk to a woman, she say to you, I'm curvy. Like, come on, I know what curve mean. You think I'm joking. You think that? Do you think really I'm so ignorant in English? I am the one who taught the American what the word gay mean. I used to go to chat rooms and I say to them, hello, gays. And they kick me out. I thought I'm saying to them, hello, guys. but turned to be gays. But I wanted to say hello, guys. But by the way, I was doing it on purpose. Otherwise, my English is like Shakespeare. Actually, even Shakespeare is an Arab. His real name is Shakespeare. But we are very humble, and we try, like, okay, we don't want to show off, and etc. We are the one who created zero, and this is why we stay in the zero. We don't have one, we don't have minus. We are in zero. We created the zero, we stay with zero. And by the way, the one who created zero is not an Arab. Jabir ibn Hayyan is not an Arab. He is a Yazidi. Some even say he was a Christian, but I believe he is Yazidi. Do we have any curved Muslim? Any curved Muslim? Who is a Muslim want to show us something smart in this religion? Until now, I did not see anything. You see, I don't want to look like I'm picking up my, you know, my stories. Maybe you can give me a story which is not stupid. Who is a Muslim can give me a story existing the Quran is not stupid and silly? Anyone? You love me? Okay. Each time I see somebody says to me, I love me, I get scared. Any Muslim here? Indian invented zeros? My friend, Indian invented nothing. We are the Arab. Actually, even curry is made by the Arab. And I will tell you how. In Arabic, we have the word kur. Kur, which means a small donkey. So we have a small donkey who was born after his mother, she passed away 4 years after. Because his mother, when she gave birth to him, it took her a lot of time, 4 years, which when she is dead, but she is giving birth. Sit down, guys. I will tell you the story, how we made the curry. So anyway, this dog, it was a donkey, right? Okay, this dog who is born of the donkey, how is a dog in the porn of a donkey? It happened in Islam. It happened. I can show you stories. I mean, everything is wrong in Islam. I mean, why you guys are telling me what is the proof of the story? It doesn't match. Nothing match in the Quran and the proof in front of you. So who is a Muslim when you're telling me that I'm wrong? I like curry too. I like Indian people too. They are very beautiful people. Very nice people. Once an Indian doctor, he invited me to his house, and he told me I told my wife not to put too much spices because I know you cannot handle it. And guys, he did not put too much spices. My head was like a shower head. I was drinking water like an elephant. He keeps saying to me, "Are you okay?" I can't even talk. I cannot even. My lips is burning. My throat, I don't even feel it. I don't want to tell you what happened to me when I went to the bathroom. And he told his wife not to put too much spices, supposedly. This is little. I mean, I will not remember that day. So since then, if an Indian friend, he will invite me somewhere, I will bring my food with me. As simple as that. Safe and safety first. Anyway. Do we have any Abdul? No. Actually, he was a Hindu. He's a very from a very big family in India. Yeah, very nice guy. Him and his wife, they are wonderful people. Actually, very very polite, very nice people. And the guy, you know, like for him, they had a big fish, you know, and but too much spice. It tastes so good, actually. The food tastes so good. I love spice, but I can because for them they eat spice always, so they are used to it, you know. So. Because the more you eat spice, the more the spice kill the, what they call them, the ones in your tongue. By the way, even those, we are the one who discovered them, the Arab. Before us, nobody discovered that. Yeah, the Quran even says that when Allah, he burned your skin, Allah will replace the skin. How Allah knew that the feeling in the skin? Magic, science. Nobody knows that. Do we have any Muslim here? Yeah, the test buds. I mean, look at the English, guys. They call the things buds. So a friend, an American guy, he called his friend buddy, and then they call the things in your tongue buds. What's wrong with those American earbuds? Everything in their language is bud. Bud Spencer. What's wrong with this religion? Even you open the book, they say to you, Mr. Brown. And Mr. Brown is white. Like, I was confused in the English. Like, it says Mr. Brown, and then there is a picture of Mr. Brown. So what's wrong with this guy? Why he called himself Mr. Brown if he's not a brown? English is messed up, brother. You want to learn the truth? Go and read Arabic. Do we have any Abdul? Is my Skype open? Yeah, we have the lights on. By the way, there is a prophet in Islam. His name is Al-Khadr. Do you know what Khadr mean? Who knows what Khadr? Who many of you speak Arabic here? Khadr meaning green. But if you read the story of Mr. Green, you will not believe it. The reason they call him green, because he drank from the fountain of youth, the fountain of life, sorry. Let me find you the hadith, hold on. Okay. I'm trying just to find you the story. What is the story? Here we go. Guys, this guy Al-Khadr, I don't know if I should read the whole story for you, because if I want to read the story, you guys, you will sleep standing. This is an amazing story, by the way. Choose a topic that attracts Muslims. Okay, let's talk about sex. I mean, what topic is this? Is the only topic that attracts Muslims? Sex. They believe in Allah because Allah will give them virgins. I mean, isn't it obvious this is what attracts them? How Allah, he attract us to believe in him? Powerful private part. Women, they have a butt which is in the size of 1 mile. And by the way, I'm so upset. I mean, only 1 mile. Or make it 2 miles, what you will lose. Only 1 mile butt. I mean, how cheap. And what if my wife, she want to do poo-poo and she have 1 mile butt? I mean, I can sell her poop for like manure. A lot of money involved here. And even I can use her fart as a destruction weapon. You put a candle and she fart, you burn everybody in the way. And now look at the story. I said to Ibn Abbas, blah, 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 okay, blah, 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 okay, okay, and that, okay, and so Al-Khadr, you see here Al-Khadr, this is Mr. Green. Now, to understand why he's called Mr. Green, then later you will find that he found, or he drank from a fountain. It's called Aynul Hayat. Anyone knows what Aynul Hayat mean? Aynul Hayat, the spring of life. Spring of life. Yes, you drink from it. Even if you are dead, you are coming back to life. And you are telling me Islam teach not teach science? They believe that there is a fountain, it's called the fountain of life, and whoever drink from it and even touch it, not only drink. And the reason Al-Khadr was called Al-Khadr, which means Mr. Green, wherever he sat, Even if the grass is dead, the grass will come back to life, will become a green. That's why they call him Al-Khadr. For whatever he put his ass in the ground, grass grow. In other way, we can say Al-Khadr, he have a blessed ass. Al-Khadr is alive, according to Muslims. He will never die because he drank from the fountain of youth, and he, or the fountain of life, he lived there too. So this is why, according to Muslims, he attend the funeral of Prophet Noah, and he attend the funeral of Prophet Sulaiman, and he attend the funeral of Prophet Muhammad. Look like this guy, he have a hobby. He attend the Prophet funerals. Anyway, so Allah told Sulaiman to find this person, Al-Khadr, who is a prophet higher than you. Take with you a fish. Look, Allah speak to Moses and he says, Moses, he thought he is the only one who learned best in this earth. A man, he came to Moses after deliver a sermon. He is a Jew. He said to him, who is the most learned person among the people, which mean about mankind? Sulaiman, he thought he graduated from Harvard University. He said, me, me, you know, but look, Allah, he was listening. He did not like that. So he said to him, then he admonished Moses and he told him not to ascribe all the knowledge to Allah, and then come to divine inspiration and said, there is, yes, one of our slaves at the junctions of the two seas is more learned than you. And Moses, when he heard this, like he would like, what, there's a guy, he learned more than me, and where, at the junctions in the two sea? The junctions of two seas, anyone knows what is that? What is the junctions of the two seas? Who knows? Okay, let us go to the map. In Arabic, it's called Al-Bahrain. In English today, you call it Bahrain. Bahrain. Do you see it? This is what he's talking about. Bahrain. Bahrain is an island, and now they make a bridge between it and Saudi Arabia. All right? And the reason they made the bridge, because they want to be sure that the Shia will not take over the island. So Bahrain is a very tiny, small island. And there is many stories about it, that in the Bahrain, there is the fountain of life. And this is, goes back to the Persian, because this is used to be controlled by the Persian in a certain time. And this is a story published and, you know, spread and believed in by many. And even you can read the story of a very famous story. It's called Gilgamesh. I don't know how many of you heard of Gilgamesh. Anyone heard of you, Gilgamesh? Nobody? Nobody heard of Gilgamesh? Yeah. You can read the stories. Those are ancient stories, and you will see how the story of fountain of life is exist in those stories. The guy who searched for the meaning of life, and he want to find the cure for people to live forever, and then he start looking for the fountain and blah 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 blah. And this is Al-Khadr. Al-Khadr is coming from those stories, which is coming from the north of you know, north of Syria, Persia, etc., spread all over. We don't know really exactly who is the first come with this story, but it's spread all over there. And this is why you will see in the hadith here, it says the junctions of the two sea. The fact doesn't say that, it says Al-Bahrain. You see, this is the word in Arabic, and this is exactly the same name for the country of Bahrain today. Bahrain means two seas, the two seas. So, and here it says, Allah, he says to him, yes, one of our slaves at the junctions of the two seas, Al-Bahrain, more learned than you. Musa says, oh my Allah, how I can meet him? Allah said, take with you a wheel. a whale, not a fish. In Arabic, it says hoot. In the basket and the wherever a fish, the fish is lost, follow it. Look, the fish is dead. And now the fish will escape the basket and follow it. This is the first zombie fish. Do we have any Muslim listening? If there's any Muslim listening. So the guy, he will take a fish, he put it in the basket, he walk all the way from Jerusalem all the way to Bahrain, which is going to take him maybe 2 months. And then there, I mean, how the fish can stay? I mean, the fish will not survive. The fish is dead. 2 months with no freezer. Put it in the basket. I mean, how long it take this guy to go from here to here? To make it simple for you, this is Bahrain, brother, and this is Israel. So Moses, brother, he is going to go from here to here, which is like almost, I think, 1,500 kilometer only, over a donkey maybe. And he had a fish in the basket. Okay. I'm really convinced. I don't know. I feel like I want to watch Harry Potter again. And then brother Suleiman, sorry, Moses, not Suleiman. He did what Allah told him. He took a fish or a whale. I don't know how he can carry a whale, but anyway, make it a fish smaller. And then he put it in the basket as Allah told him. So Moses sat along with his attendant. His name is Yeshua. Yeshua ibn Nun. Here you notice how the name is fabricated. Do you know what Nun mean? Do you know why they said Nun? Why they call it Nun? Yeshua ibn Nun. Noon mean fish. Noon mean fish. So this is a guy whose name is Yeshua, the son of the fish. I mean, it makes sense. The servant who will take care of the fish is the son of a fish. So he's a fishy story. Or the son of the whale. If you remember, there's a verse in the Quran that says Noon. Noon. Remember? And we showed you how the Noon, the whale, is carrying the earth, and the whale was carried by a bull, Bahamut, you know. Right? You forgot? How many of you forgot? The one who forgot, stand up and in one foot, next to the door of the classroom. Anyone who forgot the story of Noon, stand up and next to the door, in one foot for 15 minutes. You cannot forget this. This is science, brother. This is pure science. Noon is an Arabic letter, not a fish. No, my friend, this is not a letter first. Noon is not a letter. Here is a name. You want, okay. Are you a Muslim? The one who says to me, Noon is an Arabic letter, not a fish. Tank Battle website. Are you a Muslim, my friend? The one... Tank battle, because I can prove it to you if you want. You're an atheist. Okay, you are from those who believe that you are a monkey. Okay. Welcome to the zoo. No, my friend, what happened? There's a dog is barking. Hold on.
We have a dog parties there.
Okay, if we go in the Quran, we will find the following for the atheist guy. Noon is a letter. No, this is a word. Yeah. It is a letter for the ignorant. And we are not. All right, we go in the Quran and we read the tafsir. All right, let us read together. This is chapter 68, verse number 1. Noon wal qalam wa ma yasturun. And from his narration, I don't know how much the text is clear for you guys. Let me see. From his narration, the authority of Ibn Abbas, he said, regarding interpretation of Allah saying noon, noon, swear by noon, which is the whale that carries the earth on its back, while in water, and beneath which is the bowl, and under the bowl is the rock, and under the rock the dust, and none knows what is under the dust save Allah. Here we have to like a background music, like da-da-da-dum, because like this is like no one knows what is behind the dusk save Allah. I mean, that's it. We Muslims, our knowledge stop here. Sorry, we cannot tell you more. More information, call the customer service of Allah. And noon is coming from the Aramaic language, which is a fish. So when Muslims, they stole a name, it is this is not a letter really, it is a name of a fish. They stole it, they put it in their Quran. And here we go. The story is coming with it. Noon is carrying the earth. And by the way, this is true. It's proven scientifically that noon is carrying the earth. This is why you see those, like they call them green team, whatever. They are fighting, killing the whales, because if you keep killing whales, then their mother, which is carrying the earth, will commit suicide. And this is why we have too much earthquake. That's true story. And then it says here, and the name of the whale, please register the name, Lewish. This is the cousin of Lewish Farrakhan. And it said its name is Lotaya. And the name of the bull is Bahamut. You can search about Bahamut. You know, by the way, the word Bahamut is mentioned in the Bible, but it's a different story here. Muhammad, he make the bowl Bahamut. Okay. And some say the name is Talahud. The Muslims are not sure about the names because there's too much confusing. Because this guy, he used the whale, he used to use chat rooms. And each time he go, he choose, like sometime he call himself Christian Prince, sometime he call himself the Arabian Prophet, and people get confused. So now they do not know which is Christian Prince and which is, you know, so it's hard. It's very hard. Then here it says, the whale in the sea called Adwad. This is the name of the sea, Adwad. And it's like a small ball in a huge sea. The sea is in a Hollywood rock. Look at this, man. Look at the details. Whereby there is 4,000 cracks. I have 4,000 cracks in my head already from this religion. And from each crack, water spring coming out. And look, the Muslims, they count how many cracks down under the whale. Do we have any Muslim? This is science, by the way. This is proven to be accurate. There is a scientist from Japan, very well known. His name, Suzuki. He said this is a true story, proven. Okay, Jens, good for you, good for you. I am the best in telling bedtime story. What about like dinner time story. You guys remember only in the bedtime? And this is how boring I am. And what's wrong with you? Like, what about you remind me when you have a dinner, like a nice fish, like the friend, the Indian guy with a lot of curry? They remember me, the bedtime stories. Here we go. Unbelievable. Don't you get tired of criticizing Islam? I'm not criticizing Islam, my friend. Do you see me criticizing? How I can criticize stupidity? We criticize something smart. You know, you criticize something can be criticized. I mean, this is silly. I do not need to convince anyone that this is stupid. Aren't you sick to follow this cult yourself? I mean, how silly it is to be a human who have a brain in the year 2019 and you believe in this. What a criticizing? I'm not a criticizer. I support the Prophet Muhammad. Actually, your prophet, he says, I'm a Muslim. Yeah, he said everyone is born as a Muslim. So based on your prophet, I am an ex-Muslim. Everybody is born as a Muslim. You do this for money? Mahdi, you see, I did this all my life without taking a penny. Those donation is something new. Ask anyone. I used to open my chat room for almost 13 hours every day, teach people for zero penny. I have no books to sell. I have no donation to collect. Every day for more than, if I say 13 years, I'm not exaggerating. And I have many witnesses. And my videos, Pal Talk, is all over YouTube. You are the one who is after money. Muhammad, he says, don't approach the Prophet in a private consultation unless you pay him first. Right now, are you paying me? It's for free. I'm a person who have degrees. I can do whatever I do. I can make money. I do not need you. I do not need anyone. Instead of wasting my time here, losing my voice, getting death threat, what money are you? And how much money I made today? Here we go. I'm here. How much money? I saw somebody make a donation of $2. Thank you, by the way. That's it. So after all of this, I get $2. So Ahmadi is saying to me, you are making money. So Mahdi, he could not refute us, so he says, oh, you are doing this to make money. Oh boy. Al-Mahdi Al-Muntazar. Who is waiting for Al-Mahdi? Al-Muntazar. Anyway, yeah, but you know, the Muslims always try to discredit you. But let us see. You see, the Quran get Muhammad busted. In one verse in the Quran, Muhammad, he said the following. Oops, I hate it when I type in English, but in fact, I thought I'm typing in Arabic. Error. This website is a website of error. All right. Hey, brother. If you want to attend the Prophet in a private consultation, pay him in the front. So he will purify you. Is that right? You're a prophet. He will not talk to you. And not only that, he promise you, if you give him money, he will forgive you. Is that right? What about this? Your prophet is asking the Muslims to give him a loan, and he claimed that this loan is for Allah. And you give Allah a loan, Allah forgive your sin. I don't promise anyone to forgive their sin. You buy my books, you watch my videos, I am no one. I forgive no sin for anyone. Me, myself, I'm a sinner. If you lend into Allah a goodly loan, he will double for you and he will forgive you. This is your God. Okay, who is the one who collect the loan? Prophet Muhammad. Right? And look what you did. Here we go. See, look what you did. You see, Maddie, what you did? Look, people are making donation now. Unbelievable. Why you did that, Maddie? Why you did that to yourself? Okay, look, look what people are doing. Thank you, Mahdi. Because if you now, they are anyone who gave me money now, Allah will double your reward for you and will forgive you. How in the world, if I pay God money, he will forgive me? What kind of, I can bribe God? You can bribe God? How you can do that? So you are saying, give him money, Allah double for you and forgive you. So what I need more? Just give some money and that's it, you are forgiven, you go to heaven. Allah can be bribed. My God, you cannot bribe my God. Your God will bless you, inshallah. Look how funny you are. You just said Allah, inshallah, if Allah will. But Allah, he said he will not. Do you want to show you? Do you want to show you that Allah will not bless you? Why you don't call me and I will show you in front of everybody that Allah will not bless any Muslim? What do you think? If Allah cannot even forgive the sin of Muhammad, look at this. I want you to read this with me, Mahdi. Allah speaking about the sin of Muhammad. Guys, what Allah he said? That Allah may forgive thee. Okay, may. You are following the God of maybe. How Allah he say may? Isn't it him Allah is talking? He's not sure. He have to talk to other Allah. Allah says to Muhammad, that Allah maybe forgive your sin, maybe. What is that? This is the same as the science of the Muhammad, and they say maybe. This is about science. Don't tell me, show me tafsir. You show me tafsir. You are a Shia. You Shia, you don't have tafsir. You have shish kebab. Anyway, show me tafsir. It says maybe. Does it say maybe? لِيَغْفِرُ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرَ. And what kind of God? He forgive the past sin and the one to come. Look. The Muslims, they lie and they say that in certain time the church used to give papers to forgive sin. It's you who do that for the sake of money. We showed you the verse before it, and now we are showing you the verse where it says that Allah maybe will forgive your sin in the past and to come. How you do that? Hey, hey, Robbie. Greeting from Croatia. My friend, I want to come to Croatia. Really, contact me in Skype. I might have a trip to Croatia next winter. But don't worry, I'm not going to stay in your home. I just will eat your food, okay? Thank you, my friend. Thank you all those who made donations. Thank you. God bless. So that Allah may forgive thee for the sin which in the past and the one to come. How you forgive somebody for you are encouraging him to do more sin when you say to him the one in the past and the one to come, that's an open license for sin. We are Shia, we are not allowed to give our own interpretation. That is the most stupid answer ever I heard. Guys, we are Shia, we are not allowed to give our own interpretation. The second you call it interpretation, it is your interpretation. I mean, how silly you are. The second you say we have interpretation, this interpretation is made by who? By God? No, by a man. So this is your interpretation. Why you are a fool? And why cannot find a Muslim he have some intelligence when he answer me? We are Shia, we don't have. Okay, you know what? Let me show you the Shia interpretation. Do you want to see the Shia interpretation? Isn't you who was here yesterday and we talk about the Shia? It's you, right? It's you who says to me, show me the Shia hadith, right? I mean, it's funny. Shia. Let us love with the Shia. We are Shia. Do you believe in the words of Ali or you don't? Is Ali the who is a qualified to give you interpretation of anything? What do you think? Who is the one who says it's okay to drink the piss of the imam and even to drink their blood and to eat their poop? And the one who eat it, Allah forbid him from entering hellfire. Are you there, Mahdi? Who is the one who said that? This is your books. But let us show you something more more nice. One of the names of Allah is Ah. Is that true? Mahdi, are you there? Is it true that one of the name of Allah is Ah? You said we Shia, we don't give our own interpretation. I want to ask you, where you get this from? That one of the names of Allah is Ah. Are you there? What is that? We have a caller. Is he a Muslim or not? A Muslim Abdul want to call you and debate you, and he said he will lose. Okay, this guy here, a Muslim Abdul, want to call me. Okay. Okay, so what you call me? Today is zero Muslim. Not even a single Muslim he did call me. Not even one. So are you there, Mahdi? How Allah name became Ah? Ah? Where your Imam came brought this from? It sounds like I know. Somebody doing something wrong with this Ah. Look at this. Your prophet, your Quran says that the angels they have guys who remember how many wings? 2 and 3 and 4, right? According to the Shia, Allah, he have an angel. His name is Khurqa'il. Guess guess how many wings he have. This is Shia now. How many? Mahdi, how many? I want Mahdi to guess. Mahdi, how many? Are you there, Mahdi? Okay, let's make an auction. Somebody say 600 more. 900. No more. 1,000 more. This is too much now. You exceed, but you are close. 18,000 wing. And you say to me, we Shia, we don't make our own interpretation. Okay, tell me from where you got those 18,000 wings story from. The Quran says you have, the angels have 2 and 3 and 4. Hmm? Let us see this. The distance between the pillars of the throne of Allah, one and the other, is the same distance by flying of a bird in the distance of 1,000 years. By the way, this is still small. I mean, what is and the throne of Allah is covered every day by 70,000 color from light, and nobody can look at it from any of the creation of Allah. So how Adam in the story of the Shia, he looked at the throne of Allah, he found the name of Muhammad there, and the name of Ali, and the name of Hussein, and everything on the throne, like a ring. Here we go, the ring again. And then, and Allah, he have an angel, is called Khurqa'il. He has 18,000 wings. The distance between a wing and the other is 500 wings. And then, brothers, and then Allah, he increased the size and the number of the wings more. So he made some angels they have. And then Allah, the same angel, Allah, he gave him extra 36,000 wing. Me. And then this angel, he flied for 20,000 years. And he was flying for 2,000 years, and he did not even pass the pillar of the throne number 4. So Allah, he gave him extra power for her wings. Looked like Allah, he was making an experiment to see how far he can go, and he noticed that he cannot go farther, so he gave him more wings. It's a good, they do that in Mercedes-Benz. So let us do a translation, Google translation. Where is Google translation? All right, just to show you, I'm not making things up. For sure, translation in Google is not really good. Okay, this is about the distance between the throne's legs or the chair legs, and every day is covered by 70,000 colors of light. Nobody come from the creation can look at it except Allah, and all things in the throne in the shape of a ring. Here we go, and then. Allah, he have an angel, his name is Khurqa'il. He has 18,000 wings. Between the wing and the wing, 500 years. He fly, not risk, to the throne. And Allah, he noticed Allah, he did not have ability to, because he traveled for 20,000 years, but yet he did not reach even number 4 of the pillars. So Allah increased the numbers of his wings. You see it? And you are telling me we Shia, we don't do the same as a Sunni? Are you laughing at yourself or not? Shall I show you more? I mean, the Shia, these books are the most funny, stupid books. Huri Buta would die laughing from your Shia books. So don't tell me we are Shia, we are better. Shia don't have a breastfeeding for adult. Okay, you have something even more horrible. You rent your daughter for sex. It's illegal in Islam. If your daughter, she wanna rent her private part to the neighbor and get paid $5, you cannot even say no. Is that true or I'm lying? Your daughter, she go in the elevator. A guy, he see her. He say to her, how much you charge me for your private part? $10? She say no, 12. Because your daughter, she is like not conservative, you know, she don't accept anything. She is very tough. So she said, no, $12. You know, the guy I did before, yesterday, he gave me even 15. But because today I don't look good, I don't have enough makeup, so I will take $12 from you. So don't tell me that you are better. Don't you do muta in daily base in the Shia? So supposedly the Shia are better. They don't do breastfeeding for adult, but what they do more. They rent. Let me show you. This is your Shia website. Give me a second. Let me show you why you should be proud to be a Shia or to be proud a Sunni, because it's the same, by the way. Both of you are the same. Read with me. In some work, special term applied to women who participate in the muta. Muta mean a joy. In Arabic, the word muta means joy. And here it's about sexual joy. Musta'jara, which means she is rented. Musta'jara. Rented women. Muta'a is a considered as a kind of rental, because in general the man basic aim is this kind of marriage is sexual enjoyment of the women, and in return of this joy the women receive certain amount of money or property. So you are saying to me we don't have breastfeeding for adult, but we have this. Did you rent any women, Mahdi? When the last time you rent a Shia woman? Be honest with me. When the last time you rented a woman according to Allah teaching? And what kind of God this God is saying to a woman, you can rent your private part in the elevator? Okay, so okay, guys, look what Mr. Mahdi he said. Guys, look at this. This is Mr. Mahdi saying, we Shia do not deny muta. It is Sunni that ashamed. Imam Ali said, if Omar did not forbid one, nobody would commit zina. Thank you very much. Yes, I agree, Ali, he said that. But do you notice why? Because this is zina. This is adultery. Why somebody want to do adultery if everybody are renting women? This is what adultery is. Adultery is renting a woman and you pay her. You go to a hooker, you say to her, take off your panty and I will pay you. So Ali, he says, if people practicing this, nobody will commit adultery because this is adultery. Renting a woman private part, is it adultery? So why anyone want to do adultery? You just made it legal. So adultery, what Ali is saying, we in Islam, we don't have adultery anymore because we made adultery legal. It's legal. You go rent a woman. This is what adultery is. And actually, this is more ugly than adultery, because adultery, maybe a man, he love a woman or they love each other and they commit sin. Here, this is just a pure sex. Correct, guys? It's more shameful, more way shameful. This is, there's no love. There's nothing between this man and the woman. You know, people commit sin. All of us, we are human. We get tempted. So here you notice here that the guy and the woman, they don't even know each other. The purpose of this relationship is to rent her vagina to you. That's it. In return, you pay her money. So Islam make prostitution a business. Who care? Okay, guys, he says a woman, she have to wait for 3 months. Let me show you what he say. A woman, she have to wait for 3 months after she have sex doing muta. First of all, this is false. Because if the woman, she is over the age, which means she don't have her period no more, she do not need to wait for 3 months. However, if Allah said so, that means Allah is stupid. Because why you need to wait for 3 months? If a woman, she have a period, the second period, it's obviously she is not carrying a child. Secondly, this is what you are worried about now. She have to wait for 3 months before she do the second man. So are you saying to me that the woman in Islam, she can rent herself only for time a year? And that will make her a good woman? Guys, good, great news. Mr. Mahdi, his family females, they rent themselves only 4 times a year. Hello? Only 4 times. That's mean they are decent. I have to agree now. You got me busted. What are you talking about, Mahdi? So your daughter, she rent herself 4 times a year only. What a cult. This is Shia. No, my friend, this is Sunni too. Who said that this is Shia? Omar, Abu Bakr, and Muhammad, they practice it, and it is in the Quran. Who are you to say this is Shia? The Sunni, because they are ashamed of it. Let us see what Muhammad said. And let us see what the Hadith says. Read carefully. This is Sahih Muslim. This is Sunni now. It says, we practice muta during the lifetime of the Holy Prophet and during the lifetime of Abu Bakr and the lifetime of Umar. So who is the one who forbid it? Muhammad? No. Muhammad died. Here we go. Muhammad died and he practiced muta himself. Abu Bakr died and he practiced muta himself. And Umar died and he practiced muta himself. And this is Sahih Muslim. All of you did muta, prophet and the followers and the caliphate. All of you are adulterous and adulterer. And this is your reference. It says temporary marriage. This is the new name you give it. In Arabic, it doesn't say anything about temporary marriage. It says muta. Where in Arabic? Here we go. This is the hadith where it says temporary marriage. This is your false translation. You Muslims, you call it marriage. This is the hadith in Arabic, and your name is worried, so you should speak Arabic. Istamtana ala ahdi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa Abu Bakr wa Umar. Where is the marriage there? There's no marriage. False translation. Stantana, we enjoy it. And this is what muta is. Nowhere it says the word marriage. But you Muslims, because you are ashamed of it, you call it temporary marriage. So what you Muslims do, they give different name, different definition for adultery and prostitution. They call it temporary marriage. But as you see, the Shia are more honest than you, and they say it clearly. Well, this is a rental. This is nothing but a rental. Totally rental deal. You deny other stuff. Shia deny other stuff. Sunni deny other stuff. All bunch of you fight about who lie more. But the fact is, Muhammad and Allah, they are the order muta, and this is a proof that Allah cannot be God. Sure, and the Sunni, by the way, now they have get my book, Sex and Allah. I have tons of reference about how Sunni they practice muta these days. They have tons of marriages names. None of them have to do with marriage. None of them have to do with anything called marriage. And by the way, sex and Allah became extremely popular between the Muslims. They are astonished about how much reference they never have idea it exists. And I challenge any Muslim cleric or a scholar to say I'm lying. All your religion is about sex, from the A to the Z. Yet they claim that they are like we cover our women. You know, what about irda al-kabir, breastfeeding for adult? What about having sex around? And you call it urfi, zawaj al-misyar, zawaj al-friend, you know, anything they call you marriage. What about Muhammad sleeping with Zainab, claiming that Allah, he married him to Zainab? Have you ever heard of a marriage without witnesses? Where is the performance of the marriage? How about Muhammad flirting with his own son wife and he stripped the wife from the husband? This is Islam. It's a savage, silly cult try to present themselves or present this religion as a decent cult. But the fact, cult is a cult. It is silly, it's disgusting, it is filthy. And Muhammad, you know, no matter how much a Muslim try to protect his reputation, but the evil of Muhammad speed him up. You can lie as much as you want. While Jesus was saying that if your eye will mislead you, take it away, your prophet was saying, go guys, go do muta, find women, rent their vagina. Okay, go ahead. Yeah, have fun. Yeah. What about your prophet asking a man to go and marry a child instead of marrying a woman? What kind of a perverted man he is? A man married to a woman, she is widow, maybe. Muhammad, he don't like that. He encouraged him to get rid of his wife, and he is seducing him to get a virgin, a child. Why you don't get a young girl, a child, huh? So she can amuse you, you can play with her. So he want him, he is making the man hate his wife, who he liked very much, and get rid of her and get a child. And then the guy, he says to him, I cannot marry a child because my brother, he died and he left for me many, many children. So I cannot have one more child. Have you ever heard of a prophet like this? Imagine a guy, he says to me, I'm happy with my wife. And then I said to him, why you don't marry a young kid so she can play with you? This is disgusting. This is Satan. This is literally Satan. The guy Muhammad is trying to tempt this man to get rid of his wife and get a child instead. And here, by the way, and here we go, this is the screen, sorry for that. And here you see that the man, he's not complaining to Muhammad. I mean, there's no point. If he did not even open the topic, Muhammad, he chased him. He says, did you marry? The guy said, yes. Did you marry a woman? Her private part is used or not used? What kind of a question this question is? What is the business of a prophet of God to put his nose between the legs of the wife of this guy? Her private part is a brand new or not a brand new? What's your business? Are you prophet of God or you are a pimp? The man, he says, no, it's used. Muhammad, he says, man, why, man? Why? Why don't you? Why don't you get a young child so you can play with her? And here you notice Muhammad, obviously, he's telling us what is inside him, in his inner, how he think. He like sexual relationship with the children's. All the child molesters, they feel the same way. There's many women around them, but they go after children's. Because for them, because they are sick, they have a special joy feel toward the child. And Muhammad here is showing us how sick he is inside him, to the point he is advising his followers not to marry women who they are growing up. Go after children. And what is the wisdom of that? To play with her. Do you see the wisdom? To play with her. And here we go. Let me give you the hadith. This is the Sahih hadith, by the way. This is all over Al-Bukhari, you know, Sahih, Muslim, I mean, all over. Tirmidhi. Here we go. And the man, he told him, I needed a woman so she can take care over my the girls. I don't want someone their age. I want the women to take care of the girls. He have orphans. So Muhammad wanted him to marry a child just to pray. Anyway, guys, I think we have enough for today. I want to say thank you for all those who support us, and I hope that's you guys download the video, share it. You can cut it pieces, by the way. The video is long. Guys, I think I should make my videos shorter. What do you think? Should I make it shorter? Should I make it shorter? Because I think shorter, we can get more viewers. People maybe don't have time to watch a video for 2 hours. So maybe I should make more videos shorter. And in the same time, you guys, if I have a video which is long, you can cut it and repost it again. Like make a copy. Like now, we mentioned this topic at the end. You can cut this part and make it a video by itself. Like, and you can give it a title, Muhammad Advising to Marry Children. Right? Don't you thank me because of me, many donations? Mehdi, not because of you. That's because of the good of them. You see, you cannot deny that the Christians, they have a good in their heart. So you mentioned that whatever you mention, and then the Christian remember that, okay, here we go, let us show him that, you know, we are like, actually we are not even doing our what we should do. So it's not you, it's their good. It's their good move them to help. It's not you, my friend. But anyway, you thought you are fighting me, but look how it's backfire on you. You thought you are trying to say something negative about me. I do my videos, if people, you know, for long, I never received donation from anyone. I do my video, people donate, they don't donate, I don't care. People ban me, I go in with different page, still I don't have donation, still I do it, I don't care. And you know, I was doing there for maybe you were not born when I was fighting Islam, what donation? There is something very important. That there is some people that try to discredit you and they fabricate lies about you. But as you see, people, they make donation, they don't make donation, they are welcome. The rich, the poor is welcome. All of you watch the video equally and don't donate. Still, you can download my video. You can watch my video and you can get it for free. Even if you go to my Patreon page, you will see that those who donate, they don't have a special treatment. Is that correct, guys? Go to my Patreon, you will see nobody have a special treatment. All my videos are open for the public, which means you do not need to donate, you watch it. And go and see all the others. You will see you cannot watch the video unless you are a member who donate. I don't do that. Watch my videos. Not only that, I ask my people, please download my videos and share it in your channel. Right? So, my friend, the Lord is our provider, and we do what we need to do because this is the right thing to do. And whatever the Lord He sent, thank you, Lord, for whatever you send. The Messiah, He said, look at the birds. They are not worried about tomorrow. I never worry about tomorrow. The Lord is my provider. This guy is calling me again. Hold on. I think it's time to block you. So, in Islam, we showed you the verses where it says, if you give Allah a loan, a mortgage, Allah forgive your sin. In Christianity, nobody can bribe God. Nobody. That's your God, not mine. Read it. And laugh at yourself. Your God, He need a loan. Jesus, He spent His life doing miracles which nobody can do, and one of them is enough to make Him the most rich person ever in history, bringing people from death. How many kings they are willing to give their kingdoms to go back to life? How many people they are willing to give everything they have so they can see again? How many people they are willing to give everything they have so they can walk again? He never received a penny from anyone. He never have a slave. He never owned a donkey. He don't have anything. So while your God was encouraging the Muslim to fight and kill and steal, my Lord was giving his life to us for free, not only his service. And this is why he is my Lord and not Allah, the evil God. So don't try even to compare as long as you are following Muhammad. Do you have why you want to show it to the Sheikh? When I open the hadith, ask me to post the link, I will post it for you. Now I close them all. I'm not going to start from zero. And why you don't call your Sheikh to call me? Bring your Sheikh to call me. What's wrong with you? You sit and watch. Let us see what Sheikh would do. Where is the Shia? Where is Imam Tawhidi? Imam Tawhidi. What a funny Imam. Anyway, guys, I want to say thank you for being here, and may the Lord bless you all. Thank you for the support, for those who download the video, and for those who donate, and for those who hate me too, because your hate is a blessing to me. The Lord, he says, in my name they will hate you because of me. They will discriminate you. Even they will kill you. Time will come, and they will think by killing you, doing favor to God. But which God? Ask yourself. So, my friend, here we receive a blessing in every way. Even when they are against me, I receive a blessing. For you hate me for what I do. If I'm a person who goes speak about how to make a phone or review a phone, nobody will hate me. If I make videos about how to review water or review mineral water or stupid stuff, nobody hate me. But because of what I do, many they hate me. And that is a blessing for me. For you, you think it's a curse. For me, it's a blessing. Thank you very much for the blessing. Thank you, Muslims, for your blessing. For when you hate me, you are blessing me, because the Lord, he will give me that. Thank you. Christ is Lord. Islam is false, and we prove it every day. See you soon again. Bye-bye.